too. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Welcome if you're new. Welcome to Her Music Room, where we just talk, discuss and dissect artists, production and journeys, really. So today is a Chloe and Halle dissection. I've actually been really excited for this. This is definitely a good girl gone bad moment. This is a Zendaya joining Euphoria. This is Miley Cyrus with bangers. This is the moment where the girls have finally broken free from that kind of innocent aura that they presented to us when they were younger, just because they were young. They're now grown. Chloe is 21, soon to be 22, and Halle is 20 years old. So they're grown women. Chloe and Halle have been acting since they were quite young. Following on from that, they entered a lot of talent competitions. They were singing locally, and then they eventually started posting videos on YouTube. Now, the video that I was just watching was Pretty Hurts, which was a Chloe and Halle cover, and this is actually the cover that got Beyonce's attention. Parkwood Entertainment sent Chloe and Halle an email, and a month later they met and they got signed. Here we are now. I think this is about 7 years later. Their second studio album, Ungodly Hour, which has been doing very well. When it comes to Chloe and Halle, I was always aware of their music, but I never really tuned in until my good friend, her name's called Sonia. She's actually a UX UI designer, if anyone's interested. But she actually was the one, she literally said, listen to this album, I know you're gonna like it. And I did, and she was not wrong. It was amazing. I think I listened to this in 2018. What I really like about them is the fact that they're heavily involved in their own artistry. Chloe is a producer and a singer-songwriter. I think she does play a few instruments as well. And Halle is a singer-songwriter, and she's also a guitarist too. Chloe produced 12 out of the 16 songs on the album. 12. We've all heard the song that's been quite popular in a few adverts. As soon as you play it, people do tend to realize where it's from. I don't think that we're deep in Chloe's production. I don't feel that we are. The arrangement, the layering, the build up, the harmonies, I can actually go on. That was written by Chloe and Halle, produced by Chloe alone. The difference between The Kids Are Alright and Ungodly Hour is purely just the fact that Ungodly Hour is just less of a personal touch. This is when they started stepping in rooms with other writers. Do It was actually co-written by Victoria Monet. Just to give that kind of like pop feel their music, and obviously Do It is the hit from the album, which we know and we love. I think they're both incredibly talented, but what you do actually find within their music is Chloe has more of a marketable voice. She's got more contemporary vocals. She prefers a lot more R&B. That's kind of her genre that she stems a lot of influence from, and that's why I think her voice is more marketable. She's definitely got the lead vocals, and you can definitely tell the difference between the two of them. Even if I was listening to a song of theirs that I've never heard before, I would be able to tell, okay, that's Chloe, okay, that's Halle. Her voice is more of an alto. Halle Bailey, she's got a little bit more of a shrill tone. Her voice is very classic like. One of her biggest inspirations is Billie Holiday, and it shows. She likes jazz, she likes soul. When they did start singing and they were quite young, quite a few people were interested in taking them on. They were looking at getting signed. It was definitely up in the air before Beyonce stepped into the room. However, who is writing songs for young girls? Who is trying to market young girls? And that's exactly what their dad told them. At the ages of 8 and 10, their dad taught them how to do song structure, how to use figurative language within their songwriting, and also to express themselves throughout their music. They've got a home studio in their garage where all they do is just make their music. Their parents don't even hear their songs until they're completely done. So that's how much they're trusted with their artwork. When they did hand in Ungodly Hour and the album was given to Beyonce to listen to, Beyonce had no notes. she had no notes, and we all know she's a perfectionist. Chloe and Halle have said it themselves. The fact that she has no notes, I think, says a lot. And what I love about them is the fact that they are staying in their own lane. They're not focused on, oh, this sort, we're gonna create a big hit. They're just making the music that's for them. Wonder what she thinks of me as a personal favorite. That's another thing about Chloe and Halle. They love their yodels. They do a lot of harmonies. They do a lot of riding the wave. Since Sonia put me on to Chloe and Halle, since I listened to The Kids Are Alright and immediately loved it, I've been following them very closely. The girls are on Grown-ish as well. That actually happened by accident. They've been friends with Yara Shahidi for quite a while. That's Chloe and Halle. I hope that we have taken something away. We know a bit more about them and we can appreciate their artistry so much more now that we know how raw it is and how involved they are. They're not just thrown into the industry. These are girls that have worked hard to get where they are for years, a decade even. So that's all. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Let me know if there's any artists or any groups, any producers that you want me to dissect, just as I've done with Chloe and Halle. But yeah, enjoy your day. See you guys in my next video. Peace.